Hello boys, Sohan Bala once again, and I'm here with a poem. You can guess what? The quarrel. The moment you hear this word quarrel, I think you are filled with memories of your quarrels with your brother or sister or your friends or cousins. Why you remember these things? Because it's common for brothers and sisters to quarrel. Although sometimes they may not even be able to say why they quarrel. It's very natural among young children. But how long do such quarrels last? Very soon such quarrels are over. And how do they end? They become friends. With a little toffee, they become friends. Something as small as some promise to play together, they end up their fight. So, now let's read the poem. And this poem is about a quarrel between the poetess and her brother. Both of them quarreled, but they don't even know the reason. Because in childhood, you have no reason to quarrel, to fight. You just do it. It's part of your growing up. So, we read the poem now. I quarrel with my brother. I don't know what about. One thing led to another, and somehow we fell out. The start of it was slight. The end of it was strong. He said he was right. I knew he was wrong. We hated one another. The afternoon turned black. Then suddenly my brother thumped me on the back and said, "Oh, come on, come along. We can't go on all night." I was in the wrong. So he was in the right. This is the poem. Now let's look at it. I quarreled with my brother. That is the poetess. The poetess says she quarreled with her brother. But she says, I don't know what about. I don't know the reason. One thing led to another. Means they kept on arguing from one thing to another. And somehow we fell out. We fell out, we stop talking. We separated temporarily. We did not remain friends anymore. The start of it was slight. Slight, very mild. Something very small, very trivial. The end of it was strong. In the end, we started hitting each other. It became strong. It became a big fight. He said he was right and I knew he was wrong. That means both of them felt that they were right. And when both the parties start thinking that they are right, certainly there will be a quarrel. Because nobody is ready to accept that he is wrong. We hated one another. The afternoon turned black. They did not talk to each other. And the whole afternoon turned black. Turned black doesn't mean it turned black because of there was some darkness. No. That their moods were bad. They were upset. They did not talk to each other. So it turned black. It became useless. There was no light. There was no happiness. Then suddenly my brother thumped me on the back. Suddenly her brother came and patted her on her back. And he said, "Oh, come along. Forget about it. We can't go on all night. We can't spoil the night. Already we have spoiled the afternoon. Let's not spoil the night." He accepted that he was wrong. I was in the wrong. And so he was in the right. The poetess says, "I was in the wrong." She was proved wrong. Why? because she was not ready to accept even her mistake or make up with her brother. He was in the right. He became right. Why he became right? Because he came himself and accepted his mistake and made up with her. They became friends. He ended the fight. That means he showed his humility. He was humble in saying that, okay, I was in the wrong. See, many times we just say, I am so sorry, my mistake. Even though we know it's not our mistake. And why do we say so? Because we want to save the relationship. We don't want to fight anymore. If we want to make friends with somebody, we can't say I'm right. If you keep on saying I'm right, you can never be friends. So, let's go ahead. Let's read the summary. And the summary is, one day, the sister quarreled with her brother. The reason was very petty. Petty, very small. But they shouted at each other. The quarrel was mild at first. It was very small in the beginning, but it became strong in the end. They became each other's enemies. Both claimed that they were right, and they began to hate each other because none of them was ready to accept his mistake, or her mistake. So they started hating each other. They did not talk to each other till evening. That is why the afternoon was black. Then suddenly the brother realized his mistake. What the mistake was, nobody knows. But the mistake that he was thinking he was right, that was the mistake. He realized his mistake and he accepted that he was wrong. He decided to make up with the poetess. He walked up to her and patted on her back. And he suggested that they should patch up. They should stop that fight. He admitted that he was at fault. That was his humility. The poetess also forgot and forgave him. Because they could not go on forever. So, this is the story. Now, we go ahead with the exercises. Working with the poem. With your partner, try to guess the meaning of the underlined phrases. And somehow we fell out. So, what is the meaning of fell out? Quarreled with each other. Then, the afternoon turned black. So, that was, turned black means, was spoiled due to our tense mood, bad mood. Now, read these lines from the poem. Discuss with your partner what these lines mean. Now, what are the lines? One thing led to another. What does it mean, one thing led to another? We went on arguing. One argument led to another argument. So, one thing led to another. Then, the start of it was slight. The start, the beginning of the fight was very mild. Or the cause of the quarrel was minor or petty, very small. The end of it was strong. So, the quarrel ended on a very bitter note or serious note. We started hating each other. Then, the afternoon turned black. That means, the quarrel spoiled our mood. The afternoon became unbearably bad because they were not talking to each other, not playing with each other. Thumped me on the back. Patted on the back in a friendly manner. Next, describe a recent quarrel that you have had with your brother, sister or friend. How did it start? What did you quarrel about? How did it end? Now, this is one example, but you can write your own example. Sumesh is my best friend. But one day our relationship turned sour. Suddenly, he did not come to my birthday party. I lost temper and so did he. He remained tense and unhappy for a couple of days. Both of us were eager to patch up and we did it in a dramatic manner. We came face to face in the school tuck shop. We shook hands, felt sorry, and promised to renew our friendship as earlier. Now, this is one of the examples, but you write your own quarrel. How you made up, how you patched up, and why you quarreled. Last thing is assignment. Just a few questions which you can write in your notebook. How would you support the view that the person who wants to save the relationship agrees to be wrong even if he is right? I mean, what do you think? Sometimes we people accept our fault even though we are not at fault. Because in order to make our friendship, we just say, okay, I'm sorry, my mistake, leave it. Leave it, I accept my mistake. Even though we know it is the mistake of our friend. So what do you think? Should we do it or not? Now, my answer is, the person who is caring and compassionate means loving, is protective about the relationship. He doesn't want to lose a friend or a brother or a cousin. As in this poem, the poetess's brother loved his sibling and was caring enough to agree to be wrong, as he knew that the quarrel will go on if he didn't agree, and he gave an end to it. How did he give an end? Because he just said, I'm sorry, I was wrong. So he put an end to that quarrel by accepting his fault. Had he not done that, they would have continued to be enemies. Now, let's go ahead. Do you think the poet's brother should have acted in the way he did and why? Means, should he have accepted his mistake or not? Yes, I completely agree with his action, as quarrels lead to pain, agony and loneliness. It's good to resolve a fight than to prolong it. You know, I agree that we can accept our mistakes sometimes. It doesn't matter much if we say, I'm sorry, my mistake. So, once we, you know, resolve a fight, we live in happiness. With the quarrel, we always live in pain, agony and loneliness. We lose our friend, a playmate. Then there is nobody else to play with us if we fight with our best friend. Compare and contrast the poetess and her brother. I mean, these two people, poetess and her brother. What is the comparison? How are they similar or how are they opposite? The poetess and her brother both are too innocent to understand the reason for fight. They don't understand what the reason was. The poetess is stubborn and does not want to resolve, while her brother was willing to take the blame on himself to resolve the quarrel. So this is the difference. She was stubborn. She did not want to resolve the quarrel. She did not want to accept her mistake, while her brother was willing to take the blame on himself and resolve the quarrel. So both were different. And that is the next question. Who is, in your opinion, is right? The poetess or her brother? Now, poetess's brother is right as he understood. It is not there. This it you can cut. As he understood that there is no reason to continue fighting and happily agreed to take the blame and resolve the quarrel. Yeah, he was right, because there was no point in continuing the fight. Because that fight would have given him more pain, more loneliness. So, he was right in taking the blame and resolving the quarrel. So, that is good. And now, identify the lines that suggest that the poet's brother was humbler than the poet. Now, identify the line. Which is the line that shows he says, oh come on, we can't go on all night, I was in the wrong. This line suggests that the poet's brother was humbler than her. Right? Now, what do we learn from the poem, the quarrel? What is the learning? We learn that we may have disagreements and arguments with our siblings, but we must think logically and be considerate before drawing conclusions. Fine? That is the end of the poem. And you can write these questions in your notebook. And that's it. Let me know how you found it. Give me your feedback. And bye till then. Till the next lesson.